How to select the best 4% breakouts? If you are just new to trading, swing trading, you might as well only run one scan, which is a 4% breakout scan. What does the 4% breakout scan looks for? The 4% breakout scan is run on stocks, which consist of all the US stocks, ETFs, as well as IPOs and Chinese IDR. So, or all ADRs. So basically, it looks for a stock which is up 4% and volume is greater than yesterday's volume and volume is greater than 100,000. So three conditions are there basically. So if you run the scan today, you'll get 171 stocks. So what should you be looking at in terms of in a 4% breakout? Stock should not be up 3 days in a row. So if a stock is up 3 days in a row, that means it started going up 3 days ago. So if you're buying a stock which is up 3 days in a row, you don't need to ask who what is likely to happen. Like today, if you look at like an essay, yesterday somebody asked me like on an email saying, look, and is this a good setup? I said, no. Okay, he said, no. But it's breaking out. I said, oh, yeah, if you feel that way, then you buy. What was the problem with this particular setup? The stock was up 3 days in a row, clearly up like 2% here. This was up 3.23%, and this was up like 5% that day. The stock swing started from here. This was already 11% move. If you buy after a stock is up 11% in a swing move, you have very little like any recourse if something like this happens. This can happen to any stock, even a good 4% record also. But like, and just to give you an example, like if a stock is up 3% 3 days in a row, you should be like not looking at it. Sometimes your stock will be up just like fractional 1% and then 0.4%, and then it breaks out. That is acceptable, but where you have clear 3%, 3 days in a row, the stock is up, you should not even look at it. So first condition, stock should not be up 3 days in a row. So when you're looking at running, once you run the scan, and if you see a stock which is up significantly or 4 or 5% before the breakout itself, then that should be avoided. One caveat on this is basically if you have very low price stocks, especially stocks below $5 and all, there you will find that there might be up 3 or 4%, and then they can still break out and they can still work. They have higher volatility, so they operate very differently. Ideally, you should have a negative day or a narrow range day of less than 2% pre-breakout day. So let's look at, say, like today, look at like Goose, okay? Now Goose is breaking out. Now this had 1.66% day before the breakout, okay? WUBA didn't had a 4% breakout, but if WUBA had a 4% breakout, that would have been ideal. Why? Because prior to this breakout day, the stock was up only 0.06%. So that's what you have to look for. These are some of the criteria which will improve the probability of you selecting a better setup and the setup working, basically. Or like, and even if you look at some of the things which was like, say, this thing, when it had a 4% breakout, there was a negative day, okay? That is acceptable, negative day or a narrow range day, and then the breakout worked. Or ATHM, which is like something which I had a position in. See here, again, narrow range day. The stock was up only 0.33% pre-breakout, and then there was a breakout, and then it had a follow-through, and then I sold it like, I think here, somewhere. So anyway, so stock negative day or a narrow range day, close near high or within 20% of high. So if you get a setup which is like, say, let's look at like today, I don't remember which stock, but like say you'll come across stocks which didn't this close near the high, but like say if a stock doesn't close near the high, or even if you look at like the stock which I bought today, which is TRSC, okay, I bought it when it was up. But would I buy this stock if it was a close like this? No, I wouldn't have bought this stock like that, because you want a stock to close near the high. See, this stock closed near the high here, or the stock closed near the high here. So you want a stock which closes near the high, okay? If you apply this condition, a lot of stocks get eliminated, because if you apply the first condition, 70-80% of the stock gets eliminated automatically, negative day or narrow range day, close near high or within 20% of high. So an orderly pullback or base of 5 to 40 days pre-breakout. So you want something which has a base from which it is breakout. No 4% breakdown during the base or pullbacks. If you have too many breakdowns during the pullback or base, then there is distribution. So you want to avoid that. For stock with established momentum, select stock with linear first leg. What it means is that if you are selecting a stock which has been going up, okay, say the stock has an established trend, right? It has a trend intensity of 105, but it has a very smooth trend. It has been going up like in an orderly manner. It sets up very nicely, goes up here again, like it set up very nicely. That is the kind of smooth uptrend is what you want to see. As against that, you will find some stocks, they jump all over the place. They are like kind of too volatile. Then avoid that because you want to improve the probability of finding the best setup. So avoid choppy stocks based on past action. If it is too choppy, higher the volume on breakout day, better it is for 4% breakout. So if you see some of like, you know, this particular stock has 3.3 million volume, but that's not only the, it's a relative volume also. If you see, it's like one of the highest volume in the this entire move of like last 2-3 months. So that's what you can look for, or that is what you should be looking at. And then volume surge is not critical for dollar. We are not looking at dollar breakout currently. We are looking at 4% breakout. So we have 171 stocks, okay? What I'm going to do first is I'm going to sort it by dollar. And what is dollar? Because somebody will ask a question. Dollar is basically C minus O. So close minus opening price. So what it tells you is that Netflix for the day is up 9.98. But like from the opening price, it actually went down $4.76. So you don't want to be looking at stocks like this because they are basically didn't close near the high anyway, okay? And this way it allows you to like eliminate even low price stocks. Why don't I put in directly a filter which like an eliminates low price stocks by putting in C minus O greater than 25 cents? It just, I want to see as to what kind of stocks are gapping up also sometimes. And also it tells you, look, kind of what is happening in the market in terms of like, if you see a lot of low price stocks showing up in your scan, it tells you that the market is like becoming more speculative. So let's run through these 171 stocks and we might end up finding 3 or 4 good ideas. Okay, obviously this is not a good setup. It didn't close near the high, even the volume was high. Also stock was this here itself was up like in a 3.23, so it was not even at the start of a swing move, okay? CNET, again, stock didn't close near the high. So all these stocks get eliminated very quickly because they didn't close near the high, okay? So then we start looking at, these are really very low price stocks. And when you see a lot of low price stocks showing up, that typically tends to happen just before a slight correction in the market or a pullback in the market. So you see a lot of very low price stocks in the scans today, which is showing up. And if you have a smaller account, you can even look at some of these low price stocks, because see here, like, and this stock did make a 8% mover from this 4% breakout. So here is a breakout, which is, if you're looking at a very low price kind of a stock, looks decent to me. I typically don't take those very low priced ones. So we keep going till we find good setups. Okay, see here, like this is A, like there are a lot of negatives. One, the stock is up 3 days in a row. Okay, that itself is a negative. Stock didn't close near the high. It's very choppy. So you can eliminate a lot of 4% breakout like that. Now here you have a 4% breakout. See here, the stock is like kind of going sideways. It has established trend intensity. Close near the high also, sorry. Again, low price, very low price. And here, like, it faded the move. So see this particular stock also, like, say, faded. Okay, stock was up. Volume is high, 12.8 million shares, but, like, and I faded the move. So AUY. So this is a stock which is like, see here, the 4% breakout, it did had a 5.97% move. And this is what I, when I say, look, and if it is an established trend, like you can get a 4% breakout as a reversal, like this was the 4% breakout as a reversal. So this didn't had an established trend, but from that 4% breakout, the stock did make a move up around 25-26%, or if you look at it now, currently around 37%. So a 4% breakout like this is still a good setup. Why? Because it was like an narrow range day stock was almost closing near the high, so that was a good. Now here the stock is closing near the high. This is not really a narrow range day for 2.1, so it may be considered. I will put it currently, like flag it. And you'll also see like in a sector moves, like say a lot of gold stocks showing up today. Like last time they did have a breakout and immediately it failed. So will this breakout stick? I don't know. See stock like this, like faded, the move faded like intraday. Now this is, see, this is what you don't want to see when I say orderly base, like, and this is not orderly, okay? Sand, like, see, this is very, very choppy. The base is very choppy. So I would let it go even though the stock closed near high, okay? So the rules for selecting a good breakout, if you know them by heart, like, you know, because then you can quickly do this. So if you don't know, then you'll like, you know, have to look at them every time. See, now the stock is a bit here, like, you know, there was a 4% breakdown here, but like, you know, it looks orderly, may work. Always check last 3 or 4 breakouts. So here there was a breakout, didn't work. Here there was a breakout, didn't work. Here there was a breakout, like, and it didn't work. So I would say that I would avoid a stock like this currently. Okay, fork, fueling gobbler. Now this is also like in a very choppy, like last couple of breakouts have had choppy performance. So I would let it go. Okay. See, this stock is up technically 3 days in a row. This was up like 1.3 and then gapped up, but like any can be considered. When is the earning is 227, so possible just established trend intensity. So I would have liked it to close at the high. It just faded a little bit, but maybe. Okay, so at the moment, in the beginning, you're just like in a selecting stocks, and then you can like in a go deeper and eliminate some of them. Like now, see, the problem with this is like it's so choppy. So it's like, and I say the during the base, it was like so choppy. So even though it looks good, I would avoid something like this. Now this is a IPO, a very high volume. Obviously it faded a little bit, but volume was high, volume was for relatively. So sometimes this can work, but like again, stock just didn't close near the high. So that's the negative fate. Second day of breakout, woozy again, second day of breakout, had a follow through. That is again second day. Yeah, so yeah, Dawson Creek. Now again, this is choppy, a lot more choppy than what I would like. So and thinly traded, like in a stock traded only 20,000 shares, 19,000 shares, 11,000 shares. So a little bit like in a liquidity is low on that one also. Okay. Now that stock again, this is like in a, is up 2 days in a row. Okay. So you have this sell point technology is very choppy. Like the base is not really very orderly. So, and it's an IPO. A lot of time IPOs tend to be more choppy, and then after some few like attempt at breakout, then they become less choppy. So now this is a Lexington FinTech, which I highlighted in the morning. Now the earnings on this is on 28th. So technically, you have like in a 3 or 4 days of trading left on this because you don't want to be holding it into earnings. But this looks nice. I would have liked it to close near the high. Stock has high volume also. And see, this is like EPS, and this is the sales growth percentage, and it's a Chinese stock. So that's a positive because the Chinese stock can make a big move here, like say here. In a day, it made like, and in 2 days, it made 31% move. So that's why I think, and it still is worth taking a position in that. Okay. Now this is another one which I highlighted at $9. If you got in at that price, that was a very nice price to get into this. This was like, and now see here, like, and this was yesterday was 2.3 35, this was negative. So there is like some base from which it is breaking out. Stock has a low float. Float is 10.7 million and today 13.9 million. So more than float was traded today. So these are like when they get going, they can get going kind of stocks. Sometimes they don't get going, but they get going, they can make this kind of explosive 200% more in 5 days kind of a thing. So Oilu, I don't that's not really. NTNX, see here, couple of times it had breakout, really no follow through, breakout, no follow through. So I would avoid setup like this at the moment because it's not. See this VT, okay, again, this was up around 3.69%. So I would let it go. Hence International. Now this is something which I bought because it's again if you see this is the kind of growth it has multiple quarters of triple digit earnings growth. So it's one of those growth stocks, IBD kind of stocks. Was a good platform from which it didn't close near the high, and also the bid ask spread was in the morning was almost 70 cents or 80 cents. So you have to take a very small position because it is in a bid ask spread itself is so huge. GBT. Again, this is 3 days in a row of goods. Now, this is a very nice setup, basically. It was also anticipation setup. So, obviously, if you got in from anticipation setup, that would be even nicer. And then Malibu, it's up 3 days in a row. So, Senta, it's choppy. So, I would let it go. So, you don't see many good setups as today. But that's how the market is sometimes you get a lot many setups, sometimes it takes more setups. GWPH, see this stock is too choppy for my, when I say it's not linear, it's choppy, or look for linear trend. This is what I mean, it's too choppy. Okay, here at least it was a good setup. Here yesterday was also the stock was up almost 2-3% and then it faded, and all over the place fades are there. So can it work? Yes, it can work, but I would personally avoid stocks like this. That's 2 days in a row it is up. Now this is ARGX. It's a thinly traded again. You'll see that some days it does have a good this thing. So that's a nice setup basically. See here, narrow range day was up only down only 0.12% narrow or negative day before breakout. Baba, again, it's very choppy. Can it work? Yes, it can work. It's a large stock and there was a 31 million volume. So can it have a follow through? Yes, it can have a follow through, but it's choppy. That's the negative on that one, basically. And then your Sage again. The reason why I didn't take something like this is, see, look, 4%, nothing happened here. Again, nothing happened. See, a lot of these, it's just a chopping in this thing. Can it have now follow through? Possible, but too choppy for my taste. So we went through all the 171 stocks, and once we went through 171, you have a couple of ideas here. AUY, which is not best of the setup because it's you want a more orderly kind of a breakout happening. The volume was high, 23.5 million, but I think it has a float also, which is very high also. I'm back again. To me, it looks like 3 days in a row, so I would let it go. Then I have, I think this is a good setup. This is good setup. The only negative which I see on this is the earnings date. You should have enough time for this setup to work, but for 3 to 5 days old, I would say that can work. So I would eliminate this. I would keep this Lexi. I would keep this provided you got in early because it's already up 18%. So obviously, and Goods is very nice setup. And this is another setup. So you have 4 setups to work with. I will copy these to Momentum Burst. So if you do this regularly, you should be able to find some of these setups during the day itself, intraday. Okay. So that's as far as 4% breakouts is concerned. And what you should be looking at it, I will again repeat what it should be. Stock should not be up 3 days in a row. Why? Because if it is up 3 days in a row, the move has already started. So you're buying late in the move. or late in the breakout, especially if you're swing trading. So that is a low probability setup. Negative day or a narrow range day pre-breakout, which is again, you want like any something which has not started the move or close near high or within 20% of high. Orderly pullback or base of 5 to 40 days pre-breakout. No 4% breakdown during the base or pullback. For stocks with established momentum, select like stocks with linear first leg. Avoid choppy stocks based on past action. Higher the volume on breakout day, better it is for 4% breakout. And volume surge is not critical for dollar breakout, which we are not looking at dollar breakout. So if you go through all those criteria, you will find today that this again still has a negative in terms of like an A, but it did close near the high, relatively near the high. This did close near the high. This did close near the high. And this did close near the high. And had a negative day pre-breakout. This had a narrow range day pre-breakout, 2.35. I would have liked a narrower day, but like it's a very choppy stock anyway. Volatile stock, choppy or so. This is like in a narrow range day. 1.66 stock was up. Very nice platform or orderly move from which it is breaking out. Volume is also high. Relative volume is high. ARGX, see here the volume is very low and the last breakout didn't have a follow through. So that's one of the negatives on this one. So which is your best candidate? Goose is your best candidate. HMNI because the float is low and LX. So yeah, three good candidate to select from. 4% breakout. That's how you can find good and select the best 4% breakout. Obviously, you should do this intraday when the market is when this breakout starts showing up. And if you do a good job of anticipation, many of the stocks with good breakout, you should be able to in advance find out which is likely to break out, and you might be able to get in much earlier.